Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're gonna do a chit chat get ready with me because today it is actually the day after New Year's and obviously I had a really nice evening, so today I'm a tiny bit tired if I must be honest. So today we're just gonna be chilled and talk and do some makeup. I'm thinking of only using drugstore makeup today just to share with you that drugstore makeup can be just as good as high-end makeup. So obviously we're gonna start out with the primer. I'm gonna use the Revlon Photo Ready Skin Light Space Illuminator that is called 100 Bare Light. I'm really excited about using this one actually because I remember I used it back in the days and I wasn't too big of a fan of it. But yeah, it's always nice to come back to products and try them out again. And this is really, really illuminating as well, which I really like. I want my skin to look glowy at the moment. I just think it looks so pretty. So yeah. But I really hope that all of you guys have had a really nice New Year's Eve as well. I was just together with my family and we were just celebrating, having a really nice like evening together and just, yeah, we just really enjoyed each other's company and it was actually a really nice way to celebrate the new year together with your loved ones. My skin looks really dewy and lovely. Why didn't I like it before? That's the thing, you can totally like change your mind about products. We'll see how it looks once I apply foundation on top and so on. And when talking about foundation, Gush foundation drops in the color 004. And I love the texture of this foundation. If you can get your hands on it, definitely do. I'll try to stick to the theme of drugstore things and I'm gonna use the Sedona Lays brush in the number 928. Looks like this. Kind of like a flat kabuki brush kind of thing. Not gonna on my lip. Gross. Oh, this is such a nice foundation. It just blends in like a dream. It is so good. So this is just from one coat and just look how perfect my skin looks already. From me to you, try it. It must be a New Year's resolution to try the Gush foundation drops. I'm just gonna apply a tiny bit more of the foundation wherever I feel like I need some more. But still, if you're gonna go for that really natural, no makeup makeup look, you can just stick to one layer. I just wanna build up a tiny bit where I feel like I need some more coverage. The lighting makes me look so pale in my face right now, but it is actually not too far away from my neck and so on, so it's okay with the color. But we're gonna do some under eye concealing because I've got some bags because, as you may know or may not know, I haven't really been sleeping that much during December month, honestly. I've just been working, working, working every single day. The bags under my eyes, they tell the truth. I'm gonna use the L'Oreal True Match foundation in the color Vanilla, number 2. Very, very lightweight. It doesn't feel like that you're wearing anything and just amazing. Gonna use it on my nose as well, just cause. Who doesn't like a tiny bit of concealing? Using the best tool to blend in under eye area, your finger. So I hope all of you guys have had an amazing New Year's Eve as well and an amazing Christmas. I just feel like this time of year has gone by so freaking quickly. I'm already missing it, like for real. I can't believe that we're in January now. It's 2016. It's just like, where's time gone? I did the giveaway where you guys had to tell me your New Year's resolutions and so on. And the winner of the giveaway is going to be announced really, really soon. I just have to pick the winner, obviously. So keep an eye out for a video where I announce the giveaway winner because I will do it very, very soon. And to set the foundation and concealer, I'm gonna use the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. This is the transparent one. It doesn't really give any color. It just sets everything. And I'm gonna use the Real Techniques, what's it called, Duo Fiber Contour Brush, which I have never used for contouring. I've always used it as a kind of like setting brush. Just setting the under eye area. Shut up. And also just my T-zone, actually. It is needed. To bronze up my complexion and my face as well, I'm going to use the Bahama Mama bronzer from The Balm. And I know some of you guys may be like, oh, that's not drugstore, but I actually bought it in, where was it, like Drain Reed in New York or something like that, and I was just like, I did not know that you could get this in drugstores, so you can buy this in drugstores, at least in the US. And to apply it, I'm gonna use the Cool Cuss big fan brush or large fan brush, I'm not sure what it's called. You see that? Really, really easy. But I really do hope that all of you guys, you're doing well and that you're healthy and happy and so on and excited for the new year. I think 2016 is going to be such an amazing year. I can just feel it. There's been so many things going on during 2015. I'm just like, I was so sick and tired of 2015. I was just like, I can't wait for the new year. And now that it's here, I'm just like, more excited than ever. I can't wait to get into all of my New Year's resolutions as well and just try to follow them and keep up with them. I've just really tried this year to make some New Year's resolutions that I can actually achieve. So hopefully I'm gonna achieve them. I can do it if I wanna do it, you know? We're gonna move on with a little tiny bit of a blush. I'm gonna use the Max Factor Cream Puff Blush in the color 10 Nude Mauve. You guys may have noticed that already, but I just haven't really been into blush lately. I've just been much more into that bronzy highlighted cheek and not that much that, pinky cheek. However, I really like this shade, if I can open it. And I'm gonna use my Real Techniques Bold Metals brush. This is the one called 300. I believe this is a blush brush, I think. But we're gonna use it anyway. Not too much. Just a tiny bit of healthy cheek action. And obviously, before moving on to the eye area, I just want to apply a tiny bit of highlighter because why not? This is also from the Balm. It is the Mary Luminizer. I actually haven't used this product in a very long time, but you guys know how much I love this one. It is just amazing. No, amazeballs. I haven't said that in a long time. I'm gonna use the setting brush from Real Techniques, the greatest like setting slash highlighting brush if you ask me. You can just be so freaking precise with it. Ooh, get the glow on, girl. And even for those very natural days, I still go crazy with highlighter. I know it's not that natural, but I just really love the result. I just think highlighting, it's just the new deal for me. I love it. Shine bright like a diamond. So we just got up close and very personal. I'm just gonna use the L'Oreal Brow Artist Genius Kit. I haven't used this one in a while. And this is in the color light to medium. Looks like this, a little set where you get like a wax and a powder. The only kind of brow brush that I got from the drugstore market is the Real Techniques Brow Brush. I'm not the biggest fan of this one because it is very, very big. However, we're gonna see if I can work with it. I haven't really used it too much, if I must be honest. I think I'm gonna use the wax firstly. It is not too bad. It is just kind of difficult to work with, if you ask me at least. So the brows are on, not my proudest work, if I must be honest, but I just think that brush is way too big, and normally I love Real Techniques brushes, so no bad words about them. I'm gonna continue with the L'Oreal Brow Artist Plumper, and this is in the color light to medium once again, so it kind of goes together with that brow kit, I guess, and it's just a brow setting gel with a tiny bit of a tint in it. And now, being honest actually with how I feel about that product, because obviously my channel is about sharing things with you and telling you what I think and how I feel and so on, I've actually got some considerations to share with you guys. Some of you may be like, no, don't do it. And some of you may be like, hell yeah, you do you, girl. But I'm actually considering getting lip injections and lip fillers. And I've actually considered this for a while. I've seen many beauty YouTubers lately getting them done, and most of them, they look really, really beautiful after they've gotten them done. I mean, obviously there are always some mistakes and some bad cases, but most of the girls that I've seen getting their lips done, they look so beautiful. And now, please don't get me wrong, I don't hate my lips at all. I actually feel like that my lips, they suit the rest of my face and so on, because I have got a really tiny head and a really tiny face. I just feel like that I always try to overdraw my lips, especially my top lip, because it's way thinner and smaller than my bottom lip, and it's just really starting to annoy me because I don't want to feel like that I have to overdraw my lips every time I want to wear a bold lip or something like that. So I have been considering getting lip fillers, and I'm considering getting Juvederm, and it is obviously expensive, but I think it's worth the money if you get a really great result and if you're gonna be happy with it. So if I get it done, please don't hate on me. I don't do it for the YouTube thing. I don't do it for anybody else than myself. I'm just gonna take a tiny bit of concealer onto my hand hair, and sorry about the fake tan hands. I've also gotten so many comments on those. Please understand that I've been wearing a really, really heavy duty Donsa fake tan, and it's so difficult for me to get rid of. And I know that it doesn't look cute having patchy hands and really, really dark hands considering my face and so on, but I just had to have it because of the dawn show that I was in. And many of you guys, you're like, well, you don't have to wear fake tan even though you're in a dawn show. Well, you kind of have to, because the lights, they really sheer you out and make you look really, really pale. I've just gotten a lot of comments lately just not being that nice about my fake tan, and especially my fake tan hands, and I'm sorry about that. It's gonna get better. And because this is gonna be a really quick, simple, easy, but still very beautiful and luminous makeup look, I'm gonna use the Mary Luminizer once again as an eyeshadow on my eyelids. Just gonna use my fingers to apply it. I really like the result of an illuminator or highlighter on the eyelids. And then I'm just using the Real Techniques Base Shadow Brush, and I'm just gonna use that just to blend it into my crease. So like that. Actually, I'm also gonna use it under my brows just to highlight a tiny bit. You can do that as well, just using the same brush, because I'm lazy. This is definitely a very glowy, very luminous finish that I've gotten, and I really like it. I've got nothing against that at all. I think it looks so pretty. Moving on to some mascara, I don't feel like curling my lashes because I haven't got any good drugstore eyelash curler. And I'm gonna use another mascara than the Lash Sensational because I realize I've used it so much lately in all of my videos. You guys are probably sick and tired of hearing about it. So I'm gonna use the Gush Cosmetics Boombastic XXL Swirl Volume Mascara. I'm kind of scared when I see this brush, but actually it works so well in the lashes. And yes, I do realize as soon as I apply mascara, it does look a bit more heavy and a bit more unnatural because I have got really long lashes. I love it personally, but I know that many of you guys, you think my lashes are way too long, that I have to cut them. I've heard it way too many times, but I like it. Bold lashes, it's my thing, and I know that to many this would be very unnatural, but to me, because I'm used to my long lashes, it is actually very natural. I hope you got the point. Actually, I do feel like sharing one of my New Year's resolutions with you guys. I have been getting a lot of, I won't say hate, but a lot of like nasty comments from people talking about my lashes, talking about me as a person, just being very unnice to me. And it's people that's never met me, people who doesn't know who I am. It has been quite difficult for me to get all of that negativity because I've just been like, I do my videos to make people happy and to spread positivity, not to make people go like, you're like this and that and you look awful. It's just like, why would people be like that? I don't really get it. While me rambling on about things, I'm just gonna do my lips as well, but it just makes me so freaking sad to think of that that's where we are today in this world, that we are just all about putting each other down and just pissing on each other, I'm so sorry, and just being very, very unnice. It's like whenever you sit behind the computer back at home in your bed or wherever, you feel as if you can say whatever's in your mind, and it's just like, why do you have to tell someone that you think he or she looks bad or looks ugly? What is the point? What do you get out of it? Absolutely nothing. I'm gonna use the Gush Velvet Touch Lip Liner, which is waterproof as well, and it is in the color Nougat Crisp. Why be so gross to other people? I just don't get it. And honestly, in 2016, my New Year's resolution is not to care that much, because honestly, I have been very, very sad some days just because of all of the negativity and all of the bad comments, and it's just really gotten to me. And this year of 2016, it has to be different because I don't want to let it affect me and my everyday life. The negativity and all of that, it has to change, it has to stop. Honestly, I may start deleting or blocking messages if people are being nasty to me. Not because I can't take it, but because I don't want all of that negativity in my life. It is just, it is useless to me. So if you write a nasty comment to me being really, really awful, it may be deleted unless I feel like it's constructive criticism, because don't get me wrong, I love getting constructive criticism. I think that's the best thing to receive sometimes because you can grow from that, but just being nasty to me, I get absolutely nothing out of it, you get absolutely nothing out of it. It is just crap. So roundup, constructive criticism is more than welcome, but nasty comments, be gone. Honestly, I've had it with these motherfucking comments on my motherfucking channel. I'm so sorry, I just had to. Such bad humor. And yes, I am gonna overdraw a tiny bit because, as I said before, I like that. And now I'm gonna use such an exciting product, and I've never used it actually. It's totally brand new still. I bought it in the US. It is the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the color Abu Dhabi. I've heard so many people talk about this, especially like beauty bloggers, beauty gurus. They just say that this color is amazing, so I can't wait to try it. So these things are kind of like liquid lipsticks, at least that's what I've heard. So very excited. Doe Foot applicator. Color matches really, really well with the lip liner, actually. Makeup guys, I really hope that you enjoyed this video and this chit chat get ready with me. Actually, to me, this is a great like everyday makeup look because it's not too much, not too little, somewhere in the middle, and I like that it's so luminous, it's so glowy, it's very, very healthy looking. Give it a huge thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope that you guys are gonna have the most amazing 2016. I love you all from the bottom of my heart. Bye.